It's a comfortable spot. It's one good thing about spring. You got all these flowers and stuff blooming out. Beautiful. You see how the woods are like bright green. I don't know if you can see those white flowers down there, but they look pretty with the gobbler strutting through. You can tell they hadn't quite, all of them hadn't quite started blooming out yet, but attention in botany, I don't know what those things were. I found a gobbler. I think it's a long beard, I can't tell for sure. He's just kind of picking down this open area. You can get up a little further and I'm going to try to call it around the corner. Could be a jake, but I think it's a long beard. He was a good way away.
See two turkeys scratching about 70 yards. supposed to do that in Alabama. Had him at 20 yards. I started to shoot him just for the heck of it. That's aggravating. He had about a 4 or 5 inch beard, pretty good beard for a jay. He had about 5 or 6 short feathers on each side, so it's odd to me. Usually a super jack, I think, has got only a couple short feathers on each side, but oh well. Mosquito drilled my temple. I don't know what the original turkey was I was looking at. I thought he was a long beard. But obviously he was not dominant if he was. Because he was way on down there, and these came out close.
I gave him plenty of time to get out of this lane where I could ease out. And I got up. He was the only one in the lane still, and he was right down there on the edge. He was probably 150 yards from me. Of course, we lock eyes. He drops out of his strut. When he drops out of a strut, he putted after a few seconds. Then he struts. Then he puts, then he struts. So he's looking at a human on the edge of a field that just walked out, but he can't help himself. He's got a strut. I wasn't too worried about bumping them. I'd rather not call them back up and waste a lot of time doing it. So they went back in the woods. I don't know about where they're going to roost at. I'm not concerning myself with them, but it's getting close to fly-up time, so I need to get out of here. Back at it. Going into an area where I've seen some gobbler tracks earlier in the year. Just going to try to move through here and see if I can find something. It's getting late enough in the season, something ought to spawn in the evening. I mean, they're starting to lose hens every day. It's a beautiful day today. It's a little bit windy, but that's probably good. Might cover some of my sound when I move, but I'm just going to try to tip through here and see if I can get one struck. Walked up on a hog. I've been walking over hog rooting the entire way. I saw one. I didn't see it. I heard it crashing through this short cane right in front of me. Bad thing is it went the direction I'm going, so I'm going to bump it again. But what can you do? Rats of the South. All this is hog rooting. Look at all this. Talk about a tree. Look at that thing. Live in there. Kind of like my side of the mountain, except it'd be my side of the swamp. Thing's huge. Looks like some coon and hog tracks. couple things about today. Weather's beautiful. It feels like it's 68. A little breeze. It's not humid. Sun shining. Birds chirping. Everything's starting to green out a little bit. Pretty much perfect. The other thing is, I ran out of Thermacell cartridges. Of course, like everybody, I guess, I've got about 1,000 mats to put on my Thermacell. Always running out of the butane. Maybe I don't change my mat enough. Maybe Thermacell hadn't figured out the ratio in the packages. I would sit down and wait, see if anything comes up, but kind of torn because my Thermacell ain't working. I got a little mosquito spray, but it pretty much just shoots out like a jet. I hate using mosquito spray. Anybody else hate that? I know that's all you used to have, and I've used it plenty of times, but it puts this old hot coat of magma on you. Makes you hotter. Makes you like 20 degrees hotter. Just got one to answer me. Wrong species. I yelped, and a hog squealed. Last time I was in here, I struck up a hen right up here, so she was by herself. Are kind of alive. That's a good thing. I hate it when the woods are dead. Nothing's, no birds chirping. I'm hearing a lot of different noises, so to me that's always good. Even my stomach. Here's a pretty good example of something. I don't know if you can see, I got a bunch of different trees. I got a big pine right here. I got a, what I think is a swamp chestnut right here above me. Bunch of different oaks, but you see how open these woods are. Well, then right here, you got these saplings that stick spot. I know a lot of you probably know what I'm talking about, but if you look right up there, there's a big dead tree. Well, that created a big hole in the canopy. Sun shines down, gets to the ground, all these little saplings start popping up. It's what creates thick spots in the woods. Prime example of what a turkey will hang up on sometimes, or you don't want to come around it or whatever, but when you're in open woods like this, that's always a good thing to me because you can get close to it. You might get him to come looking for you instead of him hanging up 150 yards where he can see all the way down through there. In open woods, good to get by a thick spot and make him come look for that hen. Well, I dropped a shell. Little Super X. Winchester 12 gauge. Hadn't been fired yet. I'm gonna leave it there. Somebody may be looking for it. Finding all kinds of goodies. Somebody broke off a Wolverine 5060 Carbon Express. My money's on a hog, and they wasted their $15 or $20 arrow. Just walked through that wall of briars, great wall of briars. That's pretty much it for the day. Ain't heard a turkey, ain't seen a turkey. Don't even know what a turkey looks like. Gotta find one pretty soon. Getting a little itchy. Gotta find one before you can sit down on one. Hopefully the action will pick up at some point. Been kind of a slow go so far. Been lucky on a couple birds, but hadn't really been on, sat down on too many. But not complaining. I guess turkey hunters always want more. I'm tickled for what I've killed with the hunts I've been on. So about a third of the way through the season. Hopefully the next two thirds is good. Stay tuned.